Born to Calvin and Denise Lurie, Stacy Starr is the oldest child of three. Born and raised in Lorraine, she's a Southview High Saint through and through. Being a supporter of the Elyria Pioneers is simply her passion, and boy, does she do it well. Some folks would be surprised to hear that Stacy's quite an athlete, too.
Yes, I was a former athlete myself. I know I talked to my kids about it. When I went to Lorraine City Schools, I played volleyball, basketball, and softball. I still, you know, do a little basketball, and I could still play and throw a softball, and I could still hit a volleyball. My sisters and I taught them all everything they know, and they both went off and played volleyball in college. My sons and they all know I go out in the basketball court and I could knock down a three with the best of them too. And I would go out and pitch to my boys and take them to the baseball diamonds out around the George Daniel Field out there too. I really don't talk about it much, and I didn't go off and play anywhere in college, but I would go play beach volleyball with my sisters, and I taught them how to pepper out in the backyard, and we always put a net up outside in the backyard there too. So I would say I'm pretty athletic. They can say what they want to. They might have went off and played somewhere, but they know I can hang, so.
Being able to hang is quite an understatement. Stacy became a mother at age 20. It could have been the most frightening time in her life. But it was also during this time that her own mother was diagnosed with stage 4 uterine cancer, which meant that Stacy would now be making decisions for herself, her sisters, who were then 3 and 8 years old, and now this new baby boy. She was bound and determined to stay the course, though, leading to her graduation from college and finding success for herself and her family.
When I was in college, it was my freshman year, and I had a hard time transitioning. I was out of state, 5.5 hours away, didn't really know anybody. I was going there to fulfill my dream to play college volleyball. My first 2 weeks there, I got really discouraged. I was in a really bad funk. And I had called my mom and said I was going to quit. Forget my scholarship. I'm coming home. I can't take it. I'm not as good. I'm not going to be able to do it. And, you know, your mom comes off a little, you know, harsh, telling me what to do. When you're that young, you don't really want to listen. I still wanted to quit anyway. The next day, my sister actually drove down to surprise me. And that probably was the most comforting and rewarding feeling that I needed at that exact moment. And honestly, what I really first think of when I think of Stacy Starr is how she sacrifices her own personal wants and needs and, you know, helps others out in what they need at that time. I wasn't expecting that. I can't believe that she dropped everything to come and help me and talk to me and understand how I was feeling and make me feel, you know, happy again, and that I can actually pursue this dream and I can actually live out what I really wanted to do. So yes, that's what I think about when I think about my sister.
Both of Stacy's parents instilled a great work ethic within their children. It's all about putting your best foot forward. Through them, she learned the value of relationships. Everyone as a person is important. Her mother always made people feel comfortable, and Stacy shines her best through that memory. She wants every person to have the opportunity to be the best version of themselves.
One of the community activities that the teens and I do is we collaborate with Walls of Love to collect toiletries and other items that get bagged and put on a fence on 2nd Street. And anyone that needs items can come and grab it. It's kind of like a food bank or like a church closet that anyone that might need anything can come anytime We usually do it once a month. We're going to try to do it two times a month if we have enough items. So if anyone would like to donate anything, First Congregational Church is collecting the items for us. You could drop off any items there. We would like to help out. If you would like to help out in any way, you can help by donating items there. And we will work by our teens and our younger youth at Save Our Children will work with bagging the items, and then we will get them hung on the fence, so if anyone needs them, they can take them off that way.
Being a nurturer and a pillar in her family comes naturally for Stacy. Elyria teens achieve success, and the Murray Ridge students are an extension of that family.
In her actual profession, her being a supervisor at Murray Ridge School, I now work with her, and so I can see her in a different element than just being a parent. And working with her, I can see that there's moments where I know, just because I know her personally, like I know in her demeanor that she's so stressed and she's so tired, but those who wouldn't know her wouldn't see that in her. Like, she has always kept a smile on her face, and she's going into these situations where there's a possibility of her getting like hit or getting spit at, but she goes in and she's always smiling, and she can de-escalate a situation with ease. She's such a people person, and she is so good at her job and in loving people. I think that's what a lot of kids respond to. You know, we work in a profession where there's kids who aren't able to speak. They're nonverbal, and they're not able to, you know, with their autism, they're not able to express emotions as we do. So she's very good at admitting that, like, love and care that they are so responsive to, and they're so open and loving to her, which I think it's such a great light to see her in now. You know what I mean? So
we appreciate you for all that you do, and for the youth in our community, you put them first, and they feel it. Leadership Lorain County 2020 Emerald Honoree of Inspirational Leadership, Stacy Starr.